Hello gorgeous peeps, this is Chris from Recombu and I'm here with the Huawei Mate 20 Pro Edition, Huawei's most premium handset of 2018. It's a 6.39-inch beast, not that you would really know it thanks to the fact that screen pretty much fills the front of the phone. Of course, in order to have that full view effect, you do have a rather chunky notch up top, especially as the Pro Edition of the smartphone comes with a proper bit of 3D face modelling, unlike the dewdrop notch of the standard Mate 20 phone. It's still a very sleek design though, as you can see, perfectly curvaceous. The edges, the corners, everything is just nicely curved for a nice comfortable fit in the hand. It really is a stunning finish and it comes in 5 different colour variants as well, 2 of which support this new GOP finish. It comes in 5 different colour versions, 2 of which support this new hyper-optical pattern finish of Huawei's own design. It's kind of hard to tell, but there are some slight striations across the back of the device, and if you give it a scratch with your fingernail, or if you can pick that out, you can actually hear it is slightly textured there. So while it does feel quite smooth to the grip, it does actually help with the general grip of it and also helps apparently to prevent smears and scuffs on the back, which is a common complaint with glass-based smartphones. And certainly seems to be not quite as bad an offender as some of its strongest rivals, that's for sure. See, a little bit smudging, but certainly not too bad at all, certainly compared with the likes of the P20 Pro, which was a bit of a scuff magnet. You can also pick up the Mate 20 Pro in that lovely, luscious gradient design, but sadly not with the hyper-optic pattern, whatever it was. And the Mate 20 Pro is fully IP68 water resistant as well, so you can give it a good old Dunkin', no problem. And that display is a 6.39-inch Quad HD Plus, so as you can see, nice, crisp visuals. Getting closer, text is absolutely pin-sharp and images look fantastic. As you can see there, the colours are nice and striking without sort of really boosting off the screen. And if you jump on into the display settings, you see you've got full customization of the likes of the color temperature and everything as well. So as you can see, vivid mode as standard, but if you prefer your more realistic visuals, knock that back down to the normal mode. Like the standard Mate 20, it's Huawei's own Kirin 980 chipset, 7 nanometer microprocessor running the show. Here it's backed by 6 gigs of RAM instead of just 4 gigs though, like the standard Mate 20. So far certainly seems nice and nippy. We're looking forward to giving it a full on in-depth testing and using it as full-time handset to see how it really lives up to everyday life. And with the likes of the updated version of GPU Turbo and everything on board, should mean nice smooth performance for your games and everything else as well. The battery tech is also very exciting here on the Mate 20 Pro Edition. It's a 4200 milliamp cell, so a nice big size battery. Should keep you going a couple of days, no problem. You also get support for Huawei's on supercharge, this time at up to 40 watts. So it should be super, super nippy. So as a result, Huawei reckons you'll get an impressive 70% charge from just 30 minutes of a plug. So pretty much a full charge in an hour with any luck. And it's all nice and safe as well. It's safety certified, so hopefully no exploding phones or anything either. There's full support for wireless charging on here as well, if you like a bit of that, at 15 watts, so obviously far reduced from the standard wired charging. But they do have an interesting feature here in the Mate 20 Pro Edition as well, called the wireless reverse charge. And what this basically does is it allows you to use the Mate 20 Pro as a wireless charger. So if one of your mates has got a smartphone that supports the Qi charging standard, all you need to do is turn on the wireless reverse charging, slap your competitor device against the back of it, and it'll then take some of that power from the Mate 20 Pro and charge itself up. So I've got the Google Pixel 3 here. So turns on the charging support. Let's just try sticking this back to back. And then hopefully, there we go. Pixel 3 has started charging up, sucking some of that power from the Mate 20 Pro. And just like the standard Mate 20, you get 128 gigs of storage here in the Mate 20 Pro. Again, no micro SD memory card support, unfortunately, to give it a boost. But as you can see there, most of it is available for your apps and media. Now, the Huawei Mate 20 Pro uses a nice bit of Motion UI 9, a EMUI 9 slathered on top of Android Pie. It supports all of the standard Android Pie gestures, such as swiping away the apps, things like that. You can also flip between your apps by tugging on the side of the display, like so. And as usual, you get a plethora of bonus features right there on top of the standard Android stuff. As with the P20 series, you get some really strong facial recognition, got proper full-on 3D face modeling to make sure it's really you, not just a photo of you or something like that. And that fingerprint sensor is actually built into the display on the Pro version as well, just as it was on the Porsche model of the P20 Pro. So you see, all you need to do is just keep on tapping your finger against the screen to get it all enrolled. Hey, right, once you've actually finally unrolled your fingerprint, all you need to do is, you see there, just tap it against the screen, neat little ripple effect and you're straight into your Mate 20 Pro. The Mate 20 Pro rocks all of the usual motion controls, gesture controls, of course you get the full support for the one-handed mode and handy little shenanigans like that. And there are a few bonus bits here in the Motion UI 9 as well, such as the digital balance, which kind of popular these days. It's like a digital nanny, stops you from spending too much time on your smartphone. We'll have a full run through of Motion UI 9 and all the best new features, so stay tuned for that. So you see, one of the more distinctive features of the Mate 20 series is that square camera chassis right there slapped on the back. It's actually a triple lens camera setup with a bit of dual tone LED flash in the top left corner as well. Here on the Pro version, you get a 40 megapixel f1.8 primary RGB lens, just like you do on the P20 Pro. But instead of a monochrome lens, this actually has a 20 megapixel f2.2 ultra wide angle camera instead. And that third lens is once again an 8 megapixel telephoto f2.4 with a bit of built-in OIS, and that gives you a 3x optical zoom. So kind of similar to the P20, P20 Pro, the Mate 20 series rocks the same Huawei camera app. As you can see, you can flick between all your various modes, and there are plenty of them, just with a finger down here. In standard photo mode, of course, you've got the full AI assistant, Master AI, as they call it. That's basically just a kind of scene recognition to have you get some really nice looking photos with minimal effort. You've got all the usual move and picture modes and all that kind of shenanigans as well. And you do have full controls over the color output as well. So if you don't like the really boosted vivid colors, you can choose some nice standard efforts instead. If you know what you're doing, you can jump into the full Pro mode. That gives you control over the likes of the ISO levels, the shutter speeds. You got your portrait mode, of course, to make use of those multiple lenses. Good bit of night mode action. So again, like the P20 series, you should be able to get some really nice shots in those low light environments, thanks to the fact that it's got that long exposure, even with handheld. And if you jump into the video mode, you'll be able to shoot up to 4K resolution video at that 30 frames per second level. Still no support for the 4K 60fps. And of course, you've got plenty of other stuff on top, including my fan favorite, the AR lens, which turns you into a grumpy looking panda. And as for the selfie cam, it's 24 megapixel effort that picks out every tired little mark on your face. I'm sure there's a beauty mode in there somewhere, I definitely need that. And then you've got the usual portrait smarts and everything as well to give you a nice blurred bokeh background effect. Yes. And that in a nutshell right there is the Huawei Mate 20 Pro. Definitely stay tuned for in-depth unboxing, full review, camera tests and everything else that you need to know about this glorious handset. It certainly looks like one of the best Androids of 2018. And go check out our full hands-on with the standard Mate 20 as well to see how the Pro compares. And don't forget to subscribe for more on the latest and greatest Huawei tech and everything else besides. Cheers guys, love you.